Toledo, now out of St. Louis, and Jimmy Sevens out of Cleveland, Ohio.
What do you have?
What do you have?
About the same height, 5 feet 11. And tonight, Jimmy Sevens outweighs Archie Moore by approximately 4 pounds. 176 and a half to 180 and a half. Round number two. Best newsmen in the East are here for this fight tonight, which gladdens the hearts of those who promote the matches. In the gallery, Milton Berle, believe it or not. At ringside, Bobby Clark. And also, Abe Attell, who lost his featherweight championship just 39 years ago tomorrow to Johnny Kilbane on his birthday. He was born on Washington's birthday. He'll be 68 years old tomorrow. We'll spot them later. Is half over, a minute and a half to go. White trunks, Jimmy Devin in the black trunks, the third man in the ring, George Wall. There's the bell ending round number two here at the Technicals Arena. As Archie Moore goes back to his corner, we notice that Abe Attell is looking at him very carefully. I'd like you to meet Abe by way of... As we're about ready for round number four, there's the warning whistle. Devin seems to be annoying Moore very considerably with that dangling left hand, as you've been watching. Moore, on the other hand, seems to be lying back looking for that one big one. Round number four, Archie Moore in the white trunks, Jimmy Bivens in the black trunks, here at St. Nicholas Arena. Records are quite similar, but the records of the men that Bivens has met would almost astound you if you've forgotten. He's fought the greatest, both in names and in performance. This year, they've won them both. Bivens seemed to have the better of his two bouts in sharpening up processes. Oh. fourth round has gone by. Here at St. Nick's Arena.
Anticipated he would be after having heard his bout with Tiger Ted Lowry in Baltimore a Monday a week ago. Here comes the ninth round. That's mighty happy to bring it to you here from St. Nick's Arena. Heavyweight champion as a child three times, and on all occasions made a tremendously sensational showing. Bivens holds decisions over two present champions, as are Charles and Joey Maxim. To go in the ninth round. Round with Bivens on the deck. He's getting up without a count, which may have gone to two. George Walsh is now calling Dr. Nardiello into the ring. Bivens firing suddenly in the ninth round, seemed to hit his head very heavily when landing on the canvas, and may have suffered enough of a concussion to have this fight ending or ended at this point. So there is Dr. Nardiello now gazing, as you see, into his left eye as we watch the camera work. And Bivens hit that floor with that right hand that hit him on the temple. And so here is Dr. Nardiello as we watch him going over to see George Walsh. And this may be it. The fight is over. The winner by a technical knockout at the end of the ninth round, with his man on the deck suddenly picking himself up, Archie Moore, in what has been quite a fight.